Hey guys, how's it going? It's X666X Iron Maiden, and today we're back with more Nightwish. This is Sacrament of Wilderness and Getsemane live at the Vista Chart TV in 1999. Alright, so this is supposedly a remastered version of the gigantic title that I had to read here. In the live list of chart in, from Finland on TV, I guess, in 1999. Two songs, Sacrament of Wilderness and Getsemane. I think I'm pronouncing it correctly. The only thing I wanted to check... Okay, we also have Getsemane to do on its own, so we'll probably only do the first song. Cause that's what I thought. I think someone had told me to check out Sacrament of Wilderness from this one. The other one, we'll do it separate. Yeah, because we don't even have Sacrament. Okay, perfect. Had to make sure. Actually, we have both songs on the list. But we'll do the studio version and the live versions, I guess. I can't remember. It's been a while since they got put on the list. But I think it was someone wanted me to check this out. And then I decided I'd do the studio ones as well. So... Today we'll be checking out the live one. Let's do it. Live of both songs. Supposedly remastered too, so I'm curious. Oh jeez. Oh my god, they all have short hair. The whole band has short hair. Oh shit. This was a little early. It was the late 90s though, so short hair was pretty popular. Very neoclassical style riffs and guitar work going on here. So different, like that. I know the vocals aren't really remastered the best. You can only kind of hear it sometimes, which is a good thing. We're doing the studio versions too, but it's kind of weird seeing them so young here. Guys, rip it up the solo. Thank you. It's weird not seeing him with a bandana. Man, a lot of people said that they don't like her live because she's not as accurate, but maybe it's just she stopped caring as much live and or something, but here, for whenever you can hear her, she sounds spot on. She sounds spot on when you hear her, like, she definitely has the ability to do it live. I don't know, it makes it seem like when it got further in, maybe she just didn't care as much, I don't know. That's the only way I can see your singing degrading, you know, like... I know a lot of you are going to say that I should have checked out, you always should check out the studio version of Bola. I'm glad that I'm doing it too. It's just really nice to see something from the 90s with pretty decent sound, you know, live with them, because I have a feeling we're not going to see much from the 90s from them. Heavy riffage coming in. Remember, you guys, some of you said there's pretty heavy riffs and stuff at this first couple of albums there, so I was expecting it already coming in. Beautiful. Nice. She definitely nailed this whole performance. We'll be right back. This is before they got, like, their image of who they were, too. Like, they haven't shown their image yet of what they turned into. Still so young, so you know they're way more flashy, they, you know, experience basically than what we're used to seeing now. Badass. Oh, I'm super glad we checked this out. That was super cool. I am glad we're gonna check out the studio versions too to see like what the songs actually sound like on the album as well. It'd be a nice comparison. This reminds me of why I added to the list. It's because of the fact that it's classic, you know, going way back, music video to way back, and well, music video, sorry, live performance, I should say. It's just cool to see. I don't think we really have much of anything else from getting back to the 90s on the list, you know. Which is fine if the sound quality is going to kind of be like that anyway. It's not the best, especially the audio was basically the one that was lacking, and whenever she was singing lower, you couldn't hear it as well. But I have to say that here, this was probably her best vocal performance I've heard yet. I can't tell if it's... I know a lot of you said her live performances were not as good as her studio. Here, I thought it was as good as probably what I'm going to hear in the studio. I have a good feeling it's going to be about the same, because it just sounded spot on. It felt like that's what it should be by just listening to it. Even though I don't know the songs, it sounded like it was right. But I do know later on, even I have heard some stuff from, you know, closer like End of an Era and stuff like that, that it sounds sometimes a little off, or she'll mess up, you know, a note or something like that. And I'm just, it makes you curious, like, did she just stop caring after a little while, or did the performing become more important than making sure you sing correctly, you know, like moving around the stage, interacting with the crowd, stuff like, to a certain degree, it makes you wonder, you know, just questions, basically. I liked both songs. They're both, you know, completely different from each other, but one thing that, that I'm noticing the most is, how much the riffs are just way more intense and complex on these earlier songs. It's really cool. Like, some of the riffs and solos he was doing here and the techniques he was using, they use way less in newer songs. You know, like, it sounds like it could have been a Dream Theater, you know, solo here and there. Like, he has the ability to play super complex stuff. And as I said before, he comes off as an amazing guitarist, and here it's another example of why, you know, the earlier career, he actually can play super complex stuff, but it was amazing stuff. And then on top of that, he has the ability to make songs his own and knows how to perform for the song. It's a great combination to have as a guitarist. And coming into listening to Nightwish as a daily band, I didn't think that the guitarist would start to impress me the most, but he continuously keeps impressing me over and over again. And he's been blowing my mind. I should probably try and remember his name at some point. That'd probably be a good idea. What do you think? Where's his name? I know his name's here somewhere. Is it, it's Empu. Okay. And, yeah. Juka's the drummer. And I know Thomas. I've got Tarja. And Sammy here. But, yeah. No, I enjoyed that a lot. I hope you guys enjoyed it too. Again, I will be checking out the studio versions before someone comments, so you should check out the studio version. The studio versions will be out in the future. They're somewhere on the list. If you guys enjoyed, make sure you hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe to see more from me. I'm also on Patreon if you'd like to support the channel. And as always, you guys have a good one. I'll catch you later.